The shell is specially prepared for the priming coat with an acid wash. A final check is made for rough spots or imperfections in the finish. That the front and rear decks, the doors and bumpers are kept with the body to which they have been custom fitted. The primer paint is carefully applied to all parts. Primer is then thoroughly baked on in this oven. Before the final two coats of lacquer are applied, each body is again carefully inspected, smoothed and sanded wet. Even the smallest imperfection in the finish is noted and meticulously worked over. Coats of lacquer are applied to give the beautiful Porsche car finish. Here the body goes in to get the final coat. Note that the doors, bumpers, and decks are still with the body and are sprayed simultaneously so that there will be no color variation. Looking very much like the proverbial elves, these two craftsmen are artists in the application of the final coat of lacquer. The spray booth is dust-free, and the elves wear special masks for protection. After baking between each coat of lacquer, the body moves into the final Reuter assembly lines. Here, the body is fitted and completed. Upholstery is installed, metal and rubber strips inserted, lights, wiring harness, glass and hardware attached. Here the doors with frame and glass are being carefully fitted. Thank you. perfection, the bumpers, marked to match the car to which they belong, are fitted with overriders and rubber strips. The installation of the bumper to the car takes but a few minutes. This specialist has installed windshields for some 8 years, so he knows exactly how hard to hit the glass without breaking it. The rubber and metal frame is already attached to the glass. The rubber is formed to the exact profile of the metal frame, so that when the cord is pulled out, the rubber slips snugly and securely into the profile of the metal body frame. Each cabriolet top or hard top is custom made and fitted to the individual body. This section is devoted to the skilled craftsmanship needed for this operation. The finished body shell goes to the Porsche plant on the special flatbed truck. It is transferred to a dolly and goes into the end of the Porsche assembly line. Because of the tremendous demand for the Porsche car, the firm of Drautz has been retained to produce the Porsche Roadster bodies. Processing is similar to that at Reuter. And here, the finished bodies are coming off the Drautz final assembly line. The Roadster bodies are side-loaded onto these tandem trucks and transported to the Porsche plant. The spirit and ideals of Professor Porsche lives on today with his contemporaries who are still with the firm. Under their guidance, a group of younger engineers follow the same pattern for originality and integrity that is the heritage of the Porsche name. Until recently, assemblies were furnished by suppliers. Now, however, the major part of all critical machining and tooling is accomplished in the modern machine shop of Porsche Plant Number 2. This three-way drill is typical of the fine equipment used in tooling the Porsche components. Here, the crankcase is being drilled three ways simultaneously. This glamorous operation shows the tooling of the connecting rods. The machine tools four sides of the rod castings at once. Quality control is a major factor in the Porsche operation. The highest quality requires that testings be made by piece rather than by samplings. Here, each and every connecting rod is carefully checked out against specifications. Special gauges ensure accurate inspection of tolerances. The Porsche finned brake drums are tooled on these special machines. Again, inspection of each part is carefully controlled. Each crankcase undergoes critical inspection and a careful check against specifications and tolerances. This rotary multiple drill is drilling cylinder heads for the Super 90 engine. This interesting machine inserts the valve sleeves in the preheated cylinder heads. First for the exhaust valves, then for the intake valves. Each cylinder head is measured for volume content of the combustion chamber so that the two heads in the engine can be perfectly matched and balanced. Conditions are duplicated here with petrol being used for the measuring liquid. The exact volume in cubic centimeters is stamped on each head. This worker, who has been with Porsche for 7 years, makes the final inspection of the cylinder heads against specifications. Another critical inspection takes place here, with the camshafts being checked out. Before going into the final assembly lines, crankcases and transmission cases are steam cleaned in this special bath. In the German tradition of craftsmanship, Porsche maintains its apprentice school. These young boys are trained in the simple and basic use of tools and will gradually work into the line as helpers and then as qualified workers. This is the small but famous Porsche assembly line. In the center are two rows of cars, the final line. On the right, the engine assembly lines, and on the left, the transmission assembly line. This operation in the engine sub-assembly line shows the balancing of the crankshaft with flywheel. Note again that each one is marked for identification to be later matched together. Installing the connecting rods to the crankshaft is carefully performed here. Note that each nut is tightened with a torque wrench and tolerances carefully checked. Thank you. If you drive a Porsche, it's quite certain that the valves and springs were inserted in the engine by these deft hands. Now the rocker arm covers are put on and the clamps tightened.
Weiter. Thank you.